little me was such a big reader, and while I've gotten back into reading now that I'm an adult, one thing that I haven't gone back to read is the books that I loved as a child. So today, we'll be going through 6 books, one for each year of my elementary school life, and talking about how I feel about them now as an adult. Enjoy! I'm currently home for Easter, and I thought that was the perfect time to go through all of my old childhood books. I'm in our playroom. This is where we keep all of our old toys and books and things. And I'm always a fan of like, let's get rid of these, let's donate them. My mom's like, no, you loved that book as a kid. So now I'm actually grateful for my mom saying that, because I want to look at these and decide what I want to read for this book. Stop, it's When You Reach Me. I loved this book as a kid. Okay, I got a big stack of them. So basically, this idea for a video came because I had a dream that my mom gave me my birthday present, and it was a book for every year of my life, like my favorite book from kindergarten, my favorite book from first grade. And I don't think I could do all of those books without going to the library, just because we don't own all them anymore. But I thought it'd be fun to just go through and reread a couple of my favorite books from when I was younger, so. I don't know if you ever read the Rainbow Magic series, but this was a favorite as a kid, and I definitely want to read one of them. I was thinking I wanted to read Ruby the Red Fairy, but I couldn't find that book. The way the Rainbow Magic series worked is there were 7 books in a series. So the first series was like the color series, so it was Ruby the Red Fairy, Amber the Orange Fairy. Then they had like an animal series, so I have Penny the Pony Fairy, Molly the Goldfish Fairy, who I think I liked Molly the Goldfish Fairy, so maybe we'll keep that as an option. I remember liking Kylie the Carnival Fairy. Oh my goodness, I colored this. Maybe I'll do this one just because it's shorter and I'm reading so many books in this video. Another one, I only grabbed Meet Samantha because I knew I wanted to read this one. It was the American Girl Doll series. And I actually read the Felicity, one of her books or two of her books last summer because I was going to Williamsburg, but Samantha was my favorite doll, so I want to read her first book. Another one from when I was pretty young was the Little House on the Prairie series. And again, I had to get the first book because it's just iconic. Or actually, I think this is technically the second book, but Little House on the Prairie is just iconic. So that's gonna be my third book to read. I remember this one is Strawberry Girl. And I remember reading this with my mom. Oh my goodness. Look at my little name. I read this book with my mom, I remember, like in fourth grade before bed. And it was a really sweet book. But it's similar to Caddy Woodlawn, and I think I'm gonna have to go with Caddy Woodlawn just because, I mean, look at how loved this is. Like, it's all messed up. I remember I started reading this several times and couldn't get into it, and then I finally got into it and loved it, and I still remember parts of this book. Like, I remember she falls in the ice and all these things, so I think I'm gonna go with Caddy Woodlawn. Mysterious Benedict Society was a big favorite of mine as a kid, but I recently reread it, like, in the past few years, so I don't think I'm gonna read it in this video, but amazing book. I have 3 more books. So far we have 4 on the list, and I think it'd be nice to read 5 or 6. When You Reach Me by Rebecca Stead. I loved this book in like 4th or 5th grade, and I remember telling my friend to read it and her being like, I don't really like it, and I was like, so I think I'm gonna read this one. And then the 2 I have left, I have The Candy Makers by Wendy Mass, but this is a hefty one. This is 451 pages. And I don't remember being that important to my childhood. I just do remember reading it and enjoying it. So I don't think I'm going to read it in this video. But Hatchet by Gary Paulson is just, I feel like everyone reads this in their 4th or 5th grade class. Or maybe it's just because I did, but I don't know. I just feel like this is like a very childhood thing, and it's definitely one that I remember reading for school, and I think it'd be fun to reread and just see, like, why were we all reading it for school? Like, was it that good? So 5 books: Rainbow Magic, Meet Samantha, Little House on the Prairie, Caddy Woodlawn, When You Reach Me, and Hatchet. So we have our work cut out for us. I am
so excited to read all these books because, I don't know, it just feels like a trip down memory lane. The Goldfish Fairy. It took me approximately 6 minutes to finish because it's a very short book, but I feel like the Rainbow Magic Charm, like, it took me back to when I was 5 or whatever and reading these books. And I'm not gonna rate it. I don't really rate children's books when I read them, but I was really happy to read it again and be taken back to Rachel and Christie's world.
They're just so sweet and wholesome, and like, it's a very simple plot. It's like, this is our problem. Well, let's play tug of war. We got the fish. A positive reading experience.
Today is the next day. I'm still home. Fun fact, I don't like making my bed when I'm home. So normally I don't. And I'm going back to my room to read my second book, Meet Samantha. I'm on page 26 and I love this book. It's so cool to reread it and realize how it defined so much of my play as a child. Like, I remember I'd always go out in the backyard and pretend that I was a girl from like the 1800s or the 1900s, but the insults this little neighbor boy keeps saying, he goes, "I see you and you're really ugly. You're both so ugly, you'd scare a moose." Our elementary schoolers telling each other that they're so ugly they would scare a moose, because I don't ever remember hearing that. What a sweet book. I'm so glad that I reread this, and it makes me want to reread all the Samantha books, but I think I'm going to move on to the next book, which is my second grade book, Little House on the Prairie, another prairie girl book. I think this one was more like 1870s, maybe, that it takes place in.
And if we had made 3 more free throws.
That's why we need to get on our free throw.
Well, I like how they've been aggressive when they get lost.
It was great. I loved it. It was a blast from the past. And there is only one prairie girl that I looked up to more than Laura Ingalls Wilder, and that is Caddy Woodlawn. I think part of her being in Wisconsin and Illinois being so close to Wisconsin, and her name literally being Caroline, but she went by Caddy, her being a tomboy, like, Caddy Woodlawn was everything I wanted to be as a little girl. So reading this book again has been so cool. I'm like on maybe page 30 or something, but the stories are already coming back to me. It's so fun to be back with Caddy and Tom and Warren and Hetty, like all of these names that I'm like, this is my childhood. Like this literally, and Little House on the Prairie too. Like these books defined who I was as a child and how I played. I was always playing prairie girl. I was always like, I mapped out a covered wagon on the floor of my room in tape to see how big it was. I like put salt on my pork so I could call it salt pork. I did all of these things as a kid based on the books I was reading. So rereading them, I'm like, oh, I remember all of these things. It's so fun. And I would highly recommend rereading your childhood books. All of these books I know I'm gonna love. And actually less so with When You Reach Me and Hatchet, because those are entering a different era of my childhood. But the Prairie Girl ones, easy money. Okay, I'm officially home. Easter break is over. I'm like home in the clubhouse. And since I'm back in class, it's sometimes a little bit easier to do audiobooks rather than physical books. So right now, pulling up Libby on my phone, And we're gonna see Caddy Woodlawn place hold. 10 weeks wait? You gotta be kidding me. Next one, When You Reach Me. Okay. Borrowed When You Reach Me audiobook. And then the last one is Hatchet. I can borrow it. Oh my goodness, it's only a 4-hour book. That is incredible. That will take me like 2 hours. When You Reach Me is also 4 hours. That is incredible. So now I will be able to read those books on audio and read Caddy Woodlawn on paper.
When You Reach Me by Rebecca Stead. Nephew by Sophia Holloway.
Finished Caddy Woodlawn last night. It did not disappoint. Still love this book. I want to be Caddy Woodlawn when I grow up. Started When You Reach Me yesterday, listened to the audiobook, finished it today. I did a little bit of reading on paper last night, but mostly just listened to the audiobook, and oh my goodness, I love this book so much. I was like, why don't we talk about this book more? But then I realized it's literally a Newbery Medal book, and so that means someone must be talking about it, but we need to talk about this book more because it's so good and I forgot how good it was. And I feel like there are also things that as an adult I was like even more impressed by in this book. I started reading Hatchet, listening to the audiobook, and I'm gonna finish this tonight. I'm over halfway done. It's a really quick read, but why do we have our kids read this book? Like, why are we like, oh, you know, it'd be a good book to mandate all fifth graders to read? A book about a kid whose plane goes down in the woods and has to use a hatchet to survive. Like, I remember going on a field trip in fifth grade, or maybe it was fourth grade, where we had to like make lean-tos and learn about flint and steel. Like, do they think that we're gonna be in this situation? I don't know. But it's a fine book. Like, I don't have any problems with it. It's just sort of funny that it's such a staple book.
Loved, but at this point this book is boring me. Like, I'm on page 164, there are like 15 pages left and we're nowhere near a conclusion and it's just boring. So sorry, Gary. I really do not get why we make kids read this book.
Okay, I want to do a quick little clip recapping this video. In this video I read 6 books, 5 of which were childhood favorites, 4 of which were real childhood favorites, and then 2 of them were just books that I read as a kid. The first one being Molly the Goldfish Fairy, then I read Meet Samantha, Little House on the Prairie, Caddy Woodlawn, When You Reach Me, and Hatchet. Out of those, I think the ones that surprised me the most, or that I am most proud of my childhood self for liking, were Caddy Woodlawn and When You Reach Me. Hatchet I read just because it was an iconic book of my childhood, as I am sure it is of many of your childhoods. And honestly, I don't understand why it's such an iconic book, because it's not that good. maybe the writing's fine, but it's just like, why are we making kids read a book about surviving in the woods? Like, that sends the message that you're probably going to be in a situation in your life where you're going to have to survive in the woods, and here's how to do it. That's just what it feels like when this is part of our education. But these two books, which I guess these are both Newbery medals, so I should have known that they would probably be the best of the bunch, but they were incredible, and I highly recommend if you have children or if you are a child to read these books. If you're an adult, I don't know if it would mean the same to read it for the first time as an adult, but food for thought. As for the other three, Little House on the Prairie, Meet Samantha, and Molly the Goldfish Fairy, they lived up to my childhood expectations, and it was so fun to go back and reread them. So thank you so much for watching this video. I'm guessing it's very long because it has a lot of talking clips in it. So I'm gonna try to make this short, but if you enjoyed it, make sure to subscribe, follow us on Instagram, @lifestillis, and I will see you in our next video.